Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to cover another example, which is shopping cart prototype. Don't think it is a shopping cart. We are just going to create a basic prototype, how it can work, like adding item, removing item, increasing the total price. All these basic operations we will try to cover with basic example. Okay, so consider what we are going to do is we are going to sell our training courses. Okay, in this we were passing this data, right? Now I will do is I will pass this trainings, you can say. These trainings I'm passing instead of library, and you can actually buy, I mean you can add and remove these training items from your cart. If you click on two items, web development and design, then you have to pay 400 plus 300 rupees, something like this. Okay, now in our app.js we are getting these trainings as a props. Okay, so how we can access them? Equal to this dot props. Now we can play around with these trainings once we receive the data. So this is a service. This component will be just show you what all trainings we are providing. Now from there you can remove and add the items. Okay, so how our UI will look like, we can say that, okay, H1 our trainings. Okay, in this what we need to do is we just need to run the loop on to the services or the trainings. We can just say const training data. Oh man, this is const training data equal to what I got is trainings. I will just run a loop onto it, trainings dot map for every item. I will get two things, the index I comma index, and I will return. So here every training will have some information like the amount, the label, and also what I thought, like let's create a one separate component training, and here I will be passing all these things. Name, what I'm getting is index dot name. I will have a key which is same as index. Right, other things are like active, like if you have actually purchased this particular course, then you will have this active or inactive flag, i.active, and then we have add total. This is the function we are going to call from child to parent. We'll add this later. Okay, these properties we are passing to the training component, which we can create here. And training component can be a simple one. Where did I create that? It should be an SRC. I will just change the name of this as a training. Export default training. And we'll see what need to be written here. This is actually going to render the some data which is being passed from the app component. Okay, so this training component will have some state, like this particular item has been purchased or sold. So we can have state like active, which is initially it is will be false. Okay, now what you will have, you will have a simple paragraph tag with this, which will just show the basic information about this. So in the basic information what we have is the price and all these things. So I will just put it what we are going to have. So now if you see this, what we are doing is if this training item has not been purchased, then we will have a state active false. If this is false, no class need to be added. So what we wanted to do is we wanted to show some class, like if item is added or removed, item is added then show a different background, if item is not added show a different background, something like this. And on the on click, what we are doing is we are actually written the click handler. Click handler we have to bind with this object, so we are actually passing arrow function here. So this click handler will do nothing but it actually called the parent component method. So in the click handler, what we are doing is let active equal to whatever the current state we have, right? So we can directly say this dot set state. Instead of doing that, active equal to, we are actually toggling it. So whenever you click on it, I will toggle the state of the active, this dot state dot active. Okay, we are toggling it and we are setting it. So if active is true and false, this particular class will change. Okay, and these properties we are already getting it, so we can use a destructuring here. Instead of writing these big names, name, price, and okay, these two things only, this dot props. So from parent component, what we are sending is name, price we didn't send, we have to add it. Price equal to I dot, so you can see from here we have two properties, name and price. So we are sending name and price. Now the child component will receive both the things as a props, this dot props dot name, this dot props dot price. Okay, in this training component, so we have to import it also. This is fine. Now we should be able to link it. Name and price we got, so we can actually use this directly instead of writing this dot props dot name and price. Price we got, we are just fixing it with the two digit click handler, this dot state dot active. Same we can do with this also. So you have to write less lines of code in the actually JSX. Now active is true, then do this, do that. Okay, now we are actually, whenever you are doing click, right, we have to actually call the method to the parent component that you wanted to purchase it, because you are actually clicking into the child component. So you will be doing this dot props dot add total, right? Because you are adding, or removing, you might be adding something or you might be removing. So you clicked on to this, you will, it will get added. You click on it again, it will be removed. So that depends on if this item is active or not, right? If this item is active, so we just need to send the price. What is the price of this particular item, right? So here we will access the props for this item, this dot props dot price. If this is active, means you are trying to add, otherwise you are trying to remove this item, this dot props dot price. We can again use this concept of destructuring and we can just use price. So here I'm adding something in the price and here I'm removing, because you are actually removing. If you are making it active false, again it means you are removing the item from the cart. If you are making active true, it means you are adding something in the cart, and we are calling the parent component method. Right here also you can do it, add total, and directly call it add total. We are passing this price, add total is exist on the props, so we have to define this method on the parent component. Here add total equal to, now in this add total what we are doing is we are actually calling this method, this dot add total. You can call the same method. Here we can get the value, like some amount you are sending, right? Price, you can send this price back again, so you don't need to actually bind it to the some to the this context. And you got the price. Now what we need to do is, you got the price, so you will just append it. Either we are getting the positive value or negative value, we are not taking care of that now. This dot set state, here we will have one state object, which is the total amount which you need to pay. So total we will initialize with 0 for now, and then we'll keep increasing that. So this dot set state total equal to total plus this dot state dot total plus price, total plus price. Right, we got the updated value. Now what we need to do is, we just need to show this data on the UI, that this is the amount which you need to pay, right? So we got the we are rendering trainings, and in the bottom we can just say that this is amount which you need to pay for the services. So here we are actually rendering things, right? And we got the training data. So training data, you can put that in the curly braces, or you can put this complete for loop map inside this braces also if you want to do it like this. Just it look like lot of watch happening, right? But this is also a way you can directly put that inside an expression. Okay, trainings we got from props. We are doing a map, and for every training we are rendering the training component, which is a child component, right? This is the price, this is the name. We can just do a little bit formatting. We can just do basic formatting here. Yeah, now we can also see if we are getting any error or something. Okay, let's go to terminal. So we might be already running this. Okay, active is not defined in the training.js. Active, here we are getting active. Okay, this activity is talking about, okay, it should be this.state.active. If this is true, then add the price positive, otherwise negative. Now things are good. There might be some CSS issue. Okay, so you can see I'm able to add and remove the items. Plus minus, it has been added and removed. It has been added and removed. This should be some UI issue. I mean, we are not able to get it properly, the UI content. So let's go here where this semicolon is coming from. This paragraph tag. Okay, we have a training component. We go inside it. This semicolon we don't need. And we don't need even these wrapper because we have only single tag. Right, things are better now. You can see our trainings, and you click on it, add and remove. Initially, now you add 300. It is giving negative, right? So that is wrong. If you go to our training component, if you are clicking on it, right, then this dot set state. Now you have to take care of this, right? Now here is the better cases. You should always use callback. First we have to update the state active to true to false. If initially active was false, right, now you have made it as a true. So we can write a callback and do this there, this calling this props method. So now we will get the correct value of state, this dot state dot active. What is the current value now? If earlier it was false, now you click on to this method, now it has become true. If this dot state dot active is now true, that means we are sending the positive value, otherwise we are sending negative value. Okay, now it is working fine. You see, there is no negative value, right? So this is the second example I covered, and this example is just talking about how we are actually adding and removing items, calculating the total, how we are actually passing the data to the child component. This is the training is our child component. We are getting data from the index.js, some trainings. We receive it in the props. We are rendering, looping onto the props, rendering the training component, passing few things, right? These all are actually props. This dot props dot add total, name, price, key, active, right? And this training component is just, when you click on it, it is just calling this add total method and giving us the value. Okay, thanks everyone.